What's up, everyone? Eric Rossi, the guy with the eye here. Wanted to bring you a quick update on something that I heard and DJI kind of just did overnight, is they announced a new DJI Phantom 4 Advance. Now, if you knew last year, it's still under a year old, they released the Phantom 4 Pro. Basically, this was a fast drone, 4K video, 20 megapixel sensor. If you did the one option, you were able to have a controller with a built-in screen, which was different for DJI because that's never what they did. You always had to have your mobile device, your phone, or a tablet to do so. But this was a, you know, more of an option, $1,800 compared to just the regular one, which is about $1,500. But now it looks like they did something interesting. I don't know if they really took anything away, but with the advanced, with the standard RC, it's $1,350. With the screen, with the 1080p screen, it's going to cost you about $1,649. All early off the bat, a lot of the stuff kind of looks the same. It does look like they improved the sensor a little bit and the lens. And essentially, the only thing I don't see is that it's fast with sport mode. Because once again, this Phantom 4 Pro can go, 45 miles per hour in top speed at sport mode. But you tend to see the props within the frame. The big thing I see is its construction and its build quality and the way it's made. It's using titanium alloy with a magnesium build, offering something a bit lighter. So that's something interesting to see. And once again, for the price, this isn't bad. I noticed that the Phantom 4 was now about $1,000, and that dropped about $200 on B&H. And I'm like, why is this happening? Something's got to come. And it looks like this is the reason. Now, the lens on this 20 megapixel sensor, 2.8, it's going to be, which essentially equates to about a 24 millimeter, low dispersion and everything. It's got a couple elements on it. Max ISO of 12,800. So you're getting a little bit boost there as well. I wouldn't ever use that. It's actually giving you pretty much real 4K for the most part. 4096 by 2160, full 60 frames per second at 100 megabits per second. So you're getting a lot out of that. You're having the D-Log, and this is allowing H.265 support, which there's been continued growth for people using that. It has 30-minute flight time, and what you're getting out of the controller is 5 hours of battery life, which is amazing. And once again, with the screen, you get a full 1080p feed going back to you right there. The other step up with this is its visionary system, and as you see right here, it's got two in the front, is now that it's using five different forms. It's basically a dual-band GPS, improved range finders, and redundant sensors, which help improve stability over everything right there. These forward sensors right here can see out to 30 meters, and with that, you can also tell it to brake, hover, or detour, or go around an object that is about 15 meters away. So it's pretty intelligent for what it is, and it does resemble, obviously, the Phantom 4 Pro, but I just think that this is obviously a different option, something that they were pretty much waiting on. So This is pretty cool. The price point is way more interesting than $1,500. But the Pro, once again, that has more or less a couple more features, and it has that sports mode. And I don't see anything about the sports mode on this. So if you want to learn more information, I'll link that down below. But it has all the features that you want: draw, follow me, and everything like that. But it has some improved features, 30 minutes of battery life. It's just another option. I'm still debating, do I want the Mavic, even though I'm not happy with the image quality, or do I want to go with something like the Phantom 4? But this only being like $300 more makes the Phantom 4 look a little less appealing. If you want to just go with something like this, I don't care about the screen, 5.5 inch screen, but there you go. Just wanted to give you the quick update, quick things right here. Improved flight, improved lens, a little bit improvement on the sensor. And it just seems like it adds a little bit more than the Pro has, but the Pro has a couple other things as well if you need some more speed to it. But there it is right here. I'll leave more links and everything down below. Phantom 4 Advanced.